But I think that we also have to think about the idea of collaborating with our future selves, with our past selves. And the reason is that I said earlier you can't predict every outage, and that's true. Outages don't necessarily exactly repeat, but they definitely rhyme. And there are common patterns that we can use to decide what our engineering priorities are. For instance, if you have a bridge whose pavement deck is falling down and cars are falling through, but also, you know, it's the Bay Area, there's going to be an earthquake in the next 10 or 20 years, like maybe it needs a seismic retrofit, which one of those are you going to address first? So when we think about our complex distributed systems, we have to think about things like, how often does this happen? For instance, what if your continuous build system falls over every Friday because everyone is pushing code before they go home for the weekend? That's an outage that happens every week or every other week, right? But we also have to think about factors like impact, how many users are going to be impacted if this goes down, and how long does it take us to detect and repair it? And by combining these factors of frequency and impact, we can get an idea of which risks are the most significant, which risks have the highest frequency or the highest impact or both. And we can use the data from our service level objective to make those kinds of decisions. For instance, I can look at my service level objective and say, if I am allowed to have 1,000 bad requests out of 1,000,000 requests over the past month, and this one failure mode is predicted to cause about 200 to 300 bad requests, that's consuming a significant fraction of my risk budget and means that I don't have room for unanticipated failures. You have to make room for unanticipated failures. But the good news is, if you have this ballpark estimate, it gives a really great idea of, should I really develop that new feature, or should I fix this thing that's consuming a third of my error budget? And that way, you can really prioritize completing that work. I think it's a lot better to think more rigorously about the structural mechanisms to prevent outages than it is to necessarily chase down getting every single postmortem action item from your last outage finished.